The year is 2020. It's August 29 and I've just finished a new project. This time, a logo animation for none other than Netflix.
Wait a minute, I thought this video is about HBO.
Just hold on, alright? So, I uploaded this Netflix animation on TikTok and I get this comment from HBO Max.
Okay, now HBO Max.
Hold on, HBO wants me to animate their logo? Say no more. They even kissed me, dude. How could I refuse that? And so my journey began. I made my coffee, I plugged in the giant screen, I put on my glasses, I lit the candle. Ooh, wait. Sorry, this was from another video. I plugged in the giant screen, I put on my glasses, I downloaded the HBO logo, I opened up After Effects and I was ready to start the project. The HBO Max project. In case you don't want to stay till the end, here is the final result. But please stay, I need more watch time so I can monetize my channel. Thank you. Now, where was I? Oh yeah, the HBO Max project. Well, first of all, start by creating a new shape with the rounded rectangle tool. Then change the roundness to about 45, convert the path to Bezier path and put a keyframe on the path property. Import an image with the HBO logo so you can trace the path and then scale the image and position it so that it will be aligned with the shape. Go a couple of frames forward, put another keyframe on the path and start modifying the path until it's identical with the letter H. After you're done, add some extra keyframes between the existing ones just to make the transition between the shapes smoother and more natural. The next step is to create another shape called line. The purpose of this is to create a turn on the TV effect, so make sure you put keyframes on the scale property. Uncheck the constraint proportion box so you can play with the width and the height individually. After you're done, set the check mat of the H shape to alpha mat with the line shape. Next, we have to create the letter B. The process is the same. Create a new shape and modify its path after the original B. Add some keyframes to the path to make the letter a little bit jiggly. Then add the Venetian blind effect. Start with the transition completion of 100% and the width 80. At the end, make the transition completion 0% and the width about 40. You can also add some Gaussian blur effect to it. We have created for now the H and the B, and now we will take care of the letter O. This won't be composed out of shapes, but of two adjustment layers with a circle effect, each layer representing the two circles of the letter. The circle will be created by animating the radius and the thickness properties. For the start, make the radius 0 and the thickness about 7. Go a couple of frames forward and increase the radius and the thickness more than it should be. Go another couple of frames forward and decrease the radius and the thickness until the circle is identical with the original logo. After you're done, add a warp effect. Keyframe the start with a band of minus 30. In the middle, make it 10 and finish with a value of 0. Now add the CC wide time effect with the forward step of 1 and the backward steps of 10 and you're done with the first circle. Duplicate the first circle but change the values of radius and thickness to correspond with the original logo. The band effect and the wide time effect remain the same. We are done with the HBO letters. Now enable the H and the B and you can also add some noise effect to the H shape. I started with 98 and I ended up with 0 when the animation is done. I've also downloaded the HBO sound effect and I imported it to my timeline, but I split the layer in two parts because I wanted more space between the noise effect and the second part. The next step is to create the max title. For that, create a text called max. I used the font ITC Avant-Garde because it's the most similar to the original logo. Then put keyframes on the scale property. Start with a scale of 0% and after a couple of frames increase the scale to about 150%. Then go again some more couple of frames and make the scale 100. Also animate the opacity property so the title will fade out entirely. Animate a CC wide time effect starting with 5 for the forward steps and with 15 for the backward steps and then finish the effect with 36 for the forward steps and 11 for the backward steps. Next, duplicate the text layer. The scale property, the opacity and the white time effect remain the same, but the forward steps keyframes are slightly moved to the right. Then apply a glow effect with a threshold of 60%, the radius 32 and the intensity 1.3. You can't see yet the effect it has on the layer, but after applying a gradient ramp to the layer, the difference can be seen. animate the start of the ramp and the end of the ramp properties. For the start, the points are placed in the center as you can see. Then at the end, move the start of the ramp exactly on the top of max layer and the end of ramp further from the center. If you now enable the glow effect, you can see the difference it makes. For the next step, add a curves effect and modify the RGB and the red lines to create some contrast. Add a hue saturation effect and increase the saturation for blues to about 50. And this is what you have for now. Now let's add the original Max logo. Add a fast box blur effect and create keyframes for blur radius and opacity. Start with a blur of 33 and with 0 opacity. Go couple of frames forward and make the opacity 100%. Go another couple of frames forward and make the blur radius 0. We've created this layer because we wanted the animation to end exactly like the original logo and the text layer we had before to fade out. For the final retouches, I've also created a diamond border with the HBO wallpaper inside. In this composition, all I did was to create a rounded rectangle shape as a mask for the background. You can also add a white background with the EEX code. Tick the motion blur box for the layers to create a nice motion, and that's all. If you want, you can add a camera with a slight zoom movement like I did here. Just make sure you have the Track Z camera tool for that. And this is the final result. So, thanks a lot for watching and make sure you leave a like or a subscribe because it will help me a lot. Talk to you soon.